Ottawa. It's Canada's peaceful capital city, full of natural beauty, amazing architecture, rich history, and tons of delicious shawarma. You'd be hard-pressed to walk more than a couple blocks without finding a shawarma shop in downtown Ottawa, and it would be even harder to find someone who lives here that hasn't tried it before. It's not hard to see why the traditional Lebanese cuisine is so popular either, with its seasoned rotisserie meat, lathered in rich garlic sauce and topped with fresh vegetables, it leads to a potent yet surprisingly balanced flavor. Their Shawarma Palace Shawarma Deluxe, Three Brothers, Garlic King, Castle Shawarma, Manara, the list goes on and on and on and on and on and on and on. When searching Ottawa Shawarma, Google brings up almost 100 results. That's crazy. That is almost 5% of Ottawa's total 2,100 restaurants in the city. So what gives? Why is shawarma so massive here in Ottawa? After years of eating this stuff, I had to get some answers. Along the way, I met some of the crazy characters that make up this unique culture, heard many different theories, ate a lot of shawarma, and almost went insane trying to find the one man that might hold the key to it all. My first stop was to see my Oma. She always had an answer to everything.
Have you ever had shawarma before?
Shawarma? No.
Never. But you know what it is.
I heard about a lot.
From who?
From my children. And everybody likes it a lot.
Do you have any idea why shawarma is so popular here in Ottawa?
Because it's good meat. Plain meat, no?
Yeah. Chicken. Beef?
Chicken, beef, yeah. Mostly people eat beef, huh?
I don't know.
I think so. Susan.
Susan likes beef more.
You should ask Susan. She loves shawarma.
Although my Oma wasn't the best person to ask about shawarma, I did take her advice and talk to Susan.
Anything like that? Do you have any clue why there's so much of it there in Ottawa?
I don't know. I don't know at all why. I don't know if... You know, I mean, usually immigrants bring their food, their delicious different foods along with them. So maybe that's it. And of course, it tastes so delicious. It's going to be a hit. So I have a clue.
Since my family weren't exactly experts on shawarma, I decided to try and track down someone who was. His name was Marouche, and he used to run a legendary shawarma shop where on any Friday or Saturday night, you could find tons of people dancing on the tables to his very own theme song where he served up bazooka shawarmas. This guy was a legit legend. If anyone had answers for me, I figured it would be this man. So I headed out to his location on Elgin to hopefully talk to the man himself and maybe grab a shawarma while I was at it, only to find that it had turned into a hip new taco spot.
Do you guys have any idea where Marouche went, his shawarma place?
Where did it go?
I know it used to be here.
He's been gone for like 3 years, man.
He doesn't have a restaurant anywhere?
The one on Rideau shut down. Yeah. I think the one on the left side shut down too.
Damn. Well, if I couldn't find Marouche, I'd go for the next best thing. Another crazy character was the Garlic King. With his outrageous commercials, ridiculous van, and like Marouche's very own theme song, he was definitely a celebrity in the shawarma game here.
My name is Adelazi, Garlic King.
And what can you
honor
do?
For, I can do anything. When you're hungry, I can do any kind of food if you like, but the best way I make garlic. I'm a Lebanon from Beirut.
From Beirut.
Yeah, I was 9 years in the army, and I make the food for the army, not for army, sorry, for general captain, for presidents. I cook for them. But the difference here, I cook for everybody.
For the community?
Everybody.
Yeah. Yeah. And I can tell from all of this, you're really obviously big in the community. How important is that for you?
I be happy when I support somebody or give donation for community. I like to help. With me, I make the money. That's why I like to help everybody.
And why did you decide to come to Ottawa, of all places, when you came to Canada?
I like Canada very much, and I like especially for Ottawa, because Ottawa hard for Canada. That's why I like inside in the heart of Canada, to be in Ottawa.
Really trying to answer here, and what we're trying to investigate, is why shawarma, specifically, is so popular in Ottawa. There's many other cities in the States and Canada where it's really not that well known, but for some reason, I mean, you know, there's shawarma places everywhere in Ottawa. Do you have any insight to why?
Yes, because now the shawarma famous in Ottawa, especially in Ottawa, because me, the first one, I put commercial on the radio, and I put on TV. And everybody watch TV, example, everybody hear the radio. So the first one, me, I make the commercial for shawarma. That's why it's now it's very, very famous.
So you think you're the one who really,
yes,
who really started the trend?
100%. That's why I'm garlic king, I can do anything.
And there you have it. I already had my first answer, but I wasn't totally convinced. Although the Garlic King might have been part of the reason why shawarma got so huge in Ottawa, there definitely was more to it. And I felt that Marouche was the one who really had the answers for me. So I asked the Garlic King what happened to Marouche, and he didn't exactly give me a straightforward answer.
Yeah. So you don't know what happened to Marouche or where he went?
I don't care about him, I didn't care about me. I take care about only just my employees, same, I treat him with same for our family.
Yeah.
Luckily for me, though, I spotted an old Marouche sign on the way to the Garlic King, so after our interview, I decided to stop in and check it out. I went into the new restaurant that was called Mangiano's and talked to the owner. I asked him about Marouche. It was a pretty awkward exchange, but in the end, he went into the back, claiming that he could get his phone number for me. While I waited, I looked around at the completely empty restaurant and wondered, what's going on here? They still had shawarma equipment, and there was even a Marouche pamphlet sitting on the counter that I grabbed. Regardless, I waited to see what I could find out.
It looks like I don't have it, but they have a store in San Joseph in Hall.
In Hall?
Yeah. Okay. Not this guy, Mustafa, the fat guy. Not the guy in the picture, the other guy. But I was trying to find you, the guy in the picture, you know, stuff.
Although I couldn't get his phone number, I now had a new lead on a location and knew his actual name, Mustafa. So I headed out to Hall to check out the shop that he was talking about. When looking up Marouche shawarma online, I was able to dig up two different locations in Hall. One on St. Joseph Boulevard, like he mentioned, and another on Maloney Drive. I figured I'd start at St. Joseph and go from there. Unfortunately, when I arrived, Marouche was nowhere to be found. The restaurant was now called Manara, and when I talked to the owners inside, they said that they've been there for almost 2 years. So with my hopes dwindling, I headed out to the other location. But when I arrived, it was nothing but disappointment. 211 Maloney was just an old, run-down veterinary hospital. With the trail going cold, I was heartbroken. I had to get out of the city to recollect my thoughts and forget about Marouche and Mustafa altogether. So I headed up to my cottage to get away.
Mr. Marouche, I got some questions for you. Like, where did you go? I really need to know. Mr. Marouche, tell me the truth. What is the secret to shawarma success? Even your old location in Hull, Mr.
internet. Mr. Marouche, my God, you gotta tell me the truth. Where did you run to? Man, I really miss you. So, Mr. Marouche, got some questions.
Where are you, Marouche?
What you gonna do when the cops, yeah, that's me, they come for you, and I need and I get these answers from you, like, why is Ottawa the... Feeling refreshed and like I got Marouche completely out of my mind, I decided to head back into Ottawa and see if I could talk to some of the people on the street, see what they thought about Shawarma in Ottawa, see if they had any answers for me. Take a look how it went.
Why do you think shawarma is so? And why do you think shawarma is so popular in Ottawa specifically, more so than other cities here?
Honestly, I have no idea why it's not more popular than the other cities. It's just so affordable. It's fresh. It tastes amazing.
I think shawarma is so big in Ottawa because it is probably one of the top five foods anyone could ever have.
maybe the Lebanese community is way more stronger here. Yeah. Like, they have more like home recipes, you know, from the fucking homeland or whatever.
I really don't know what it is. I think maybe one guy opened one up, it took off, everybody might have copied him. I have no idea why.
I don't know that verse.
It caters to both the drunk and the sober people. Everybody loves shawarma. Be them drunk, sober, high, I don't fucking care. Everybody loves shawarma. Everybody.
People, they like fresh food. They like shawarma is fresh. Everything is fresh. They like it. They go fresh. Yeah.
I think it's just because like there's so much like shawarma like places in Ottawa that it's hard not to be a big thing.
Yeah.
Like, they're so popular here, like, it's hard not to, to like, try it out.
Probably the huge Arab or Lebanese community, let's be honest. Yeah.
The people of our, they love garlic.
I think it's a huge thing because the Ottawa itself wants to be a little more multicultural, and I think they want to be, because it is the capital of many provinces as well as countries.
Ottawa just cares just that slightest bitch. It's that slightest bitch more. Yeah.
But why in Ottawa? Why is it popular in Ottawa?
In Ottawa? I don't know why it's popular in Ottawa, but I enjoy the fact that it's become a staple of our existence here.
Although most people's answers lacked any real substance, I was lucky enough to interview a couple more shawarma VIPs and hear what they had to say.
Shawarma just doesn't have the same traction.
It's simple. Most of the chefs, when they come from another country, they'll go to the capital. That's where they're expected to be the most jobs. So everybody that really has knowledge will go to the capital, and that's why there's so many shawarmas in Ottawa, and it's better than other places. Because the chefs, when they apply to come over to a country, they'll come to the capital.
So my name is Joe. I work in Shawarma Deluxe for a long time, and I do my best. Because big Lebanese community in Ottawa, so people always trying something different. Every place you go, you don't get the same taste because the quality is also different. Anybody besides the Lebanese who making it also to give you different taste. So that's why you always see that thing happen. On top of that, the city will play a big role. Before, used to have like a distance between place and place. So now they don't care anymore. They give you that short distance. You good, good price, good quality, good service, you survive. You don't, goodbye, Charlie.
Nation here, it's very large in Ottawa.
Yes, and Ottawa and Montreal is big. And that's why you see, if you go to Toronto, you see Lebanese, but who makes it this type of food also different. I have nothing against anybody, but the taste. Like I said before, the city was have a distance. 7 blocks in each kind of business, even pizza, grocery, shawarma, any kind. After 2000, the city would decide to make, to give everybody a chance. If you want to open 100,000 places, the same thing, go open. You're your chance. You survive, you don't. Easy and simple.
Yeah.
just like a war inside of the city, you know, so everybody wants to eat something.
Although most of the theories I heard were pretty much nonsense, there were a couple things I wanted to check out. First of which was the law change that Joe had mentioned. Although I couldn't find anything about the previous laws, after looking extensively through Ottawa's current zoning regulations, there was absolutely nothing restricting two businesses that were similar being near each other. So maybe Joe was right. Maybe it was partially because anyone could open a shawarma shop wherever they wanted in Ottawa. The second thing I wanted to check was regarding the Lebanese population here in Ottawa. And after looking at the StatsCan website, it looked like there was actually something behind it. According to the site, over 2% of the total population was Lebanese in Ottawa, quite a bit higher than the 1% that other major cities held in the rest of the country. So after all that searching, it appeared I found the answer, and it was quite simple. Ottawa just had a lot of Lebanese people, and with a lot of Lebanese people came a lot of shawarma. I'm sure it also helped that Ottawa had no regulations against how many shawarma shops could be opened and where they could be opened. And the fact that there were plenty of great community leaders like Adele who were promoting the gospel of shawarma. All in all, I think I figured it out. And I should have been able to go home happy, close my eyes, and call it a day. But something was still in the back of my mind. Mustafa and his shawarma shop Marouche. Over and over again, I retraced my steps that I took trying to find him. I thought that there must be something I have missed. There must be some sort of clue that would lead me to find Mustafa. If I just looked hard enough, I would find it. Finally, after all that time, I realized I had never called the number on the pamphlet I found at Menaggio's Pizza. I figured, what the hell? I should give it a try.
Just calling the Marouche number here that I found off an old pamphlet. Hello, this is Marouche Restaurant?
Yeah.
Oh, awesome. Where are you guys located? Yeah, sure. Hey, how's it going? Good. I'm just wondering where you guys are located now so I could come get some shawarma.
Alright, it comes from the medical center.
From where?
The medical center. You know where the medical center is?
No, I'm not sure. And where is this one? St. Joseph in Orleans, and it's called Marouche?
Yeah.
Okay, what's...
That is 2564 here in St. Joseph.
2564.
Exactly.
Okay, perfect. Thanks, man. Bye.
I couldn't believe it. The hunt was back on. I looked up the address and it led to none other than Mangiano Pizza. So what was going on here? Why were they answering a different number as Marouche when they had their own phone number from Mangiano? And why all the secrecy about their location? I decided to head down and get some answers.
Hey man. Good, good. It's Marouche Shawarma? Hey. Yeah, I was here before looking for Marouche because I wanted to interview him, and I couldn't find the place in Orleans. This is one of his restaurants, though?
This is the only place, and the other one, it's in San Joseph and all, but...
Uh... If you have the phone number address for out there, because he doesn't work this one anymore.
Mustafa's not working, but he's the one who should be doing the interview. He's don't have his phone number. You don't have, he's in the house. He's working. I don't know if he's working somewhere, but he's not working.
No, he's not working in the restaurant anymore?
Yeah, but he was here for a couple of weeks.
Okay. So you just kept the Marouche name here for your one, but he's not like working here.
I read his number a couple of days ago in the paper. But 90% that's his number. His name is Mustafa, 797-4735.
Okay, awesome, man. I'll give him a call and I'll go down there as well to a hall and see what I can find.
There is one San Joseph and Hall.
Okay. Okay. Cool. Well, thanks a lot, man.
Okay, man.
So back I headed to Hall, but this time with the address of their new location. And this time, I was pleasantly surprised. Marouche International Shawarma existed, and I'd finally found it. Unfortunately for me though, once again Mustafa was nowhere to be found. The current owner Nadim was his old business partner, but they had split ties years ago. He had no clue where he currently was. That being said, they had worked together for years, so I figured he had some pretty crazy stories from those times. And he was nice enough to give me an interview.
My name is Nadim.
And what do you do here?
I'm the owner of the Marouche.
And how long have you owned the Marouche for?
For general or location? Location.
Both.
In general since 1990, March 1st, 1990.
Hello.
Yeah, in general it's getting popular. Like as I said, like 25 years ago it was rarely you see a shawarma around, but now every corner you can see a shawarma. Even here in Hall, when we opened up almost 12 years ago, we used to be the only location in San Joseph. If you go around San Joseph from far to east, San Joseph, almost 12 location now. In Algin Street, we have too many. The busy bar was Bulldogs. I don't know if you know Bulldogs.
Yeah, I remember.
Yeah, Bulldogs and dancing on the table. And we still have the song Marouche. I don't know if you remember Marouche song.
Yeah, of course I do. I used to go all the time.
Yeah, and you remember the picture on the wall, like the crazy picture.
And then I remember girls dancing on the counter.
Exactly.
And it was just crazy.
Yeah, exactly. So we used to have fun. You know, it's an Algin Street. It was a different type of business. Yeah, it's a shawarma. And after hour, we call it night time.
Do you have any a story you want to share from anything that really sticks out to you from one of those late night times working there?
Well, too many is try to make up remembers. So many stories
I'm
sure. Yeah, but it's all actions. We have, I don't know, it's stories to come up here. Some stories, bad stories at night, you know, like dancing happened too much. No fight.
No one wants a fight.
No, yeah. So, yeah, it was fun. We missed it, but not anymore. We're old now.
Yeah. You had your glory time.
Oh, right? Yeah.
Good stuff.
Yeah.
Although he was pretty tight-lipped about the stories, he did end up showing me some old pictures from back in the day. Seeing those pictures proved how crazy it really was, so the legends were all true. I was all the more curious and knew I had to find the man from the front lines, Mustafa. He would be the one who would be able to tell me the stories that go behind all these photos.
Yeah.
And you used to have another partner, Mustafa, who I've been
Mustafa, yeah. Since we left Algin Street, we used to be down here. We opened another location in Gatineau, but I moved out from Gatineau. He's still in Gatineau. Now he sold the Gatineau side. I don't know if you want to his location in New Orleans. Have you tried New Orleans?
Yeah, we've been by.
Yeah, so I don't know where he is now, right now. I have no idea.
No.
He's alone. He's... he's kind of retired from shawarmas. Yeah.
So I ordered a couple shawarmas that they were nice enough to give me free of charge.
Nice. Normal. No shawarma for you.
And I headed back home to give Mustafa's number a call. Hey, is this Mustafa? Hey Mustafa, my name is Connor DeVries. I'm doing a little documentary for school about shawarma in Ottawa, about the whole shawarma culture in Ottawa. And I was wondering if you'd be willing to meet with me just for like maybe 20-30 minutes just to do a quick interview, because I know you used to be, you know, have a bunch of restaurants.
Sure, we're coming on Monday.
Okay, and where am I coming into?
Pardon?
Give you a call on Monday? Okay.
And ask him how we can do it.
Okay, and then I'll come meet you somewhere. Thanks so much.
Okay. You know, what's your name?
Connor.
Connor, eh?
Yeah. Good to meet you.
Okay, so much.
Okay, thanks. I'll give you a call.
Okay, no problem.
Okay, bye. So I waited patiently and gave him a call on Monday. And again on Tuesday. And Wednesday. I kept on calling until he eventually answered again. Hi, Mustafa? Good. How you doing?
Good.
Yeah, this is Connor. We talked on Friday about the documentary.
Ah, documentary. What are you talking about me? How do you know about me?
Because I used to go to your shawarma place on Elgin back in the day.
Long time ago, eh?
But is there any way you could do a quick interview with me?
I'm really busy like day and night, it's a problem, but my partner in Garden Hall, he can take over, and he knows, he has a shawarma place, and he'll help you up.
Yeah, I know, but part of it was because I always used to go and see you, you know, and get your shawarma at Elgin back in the day. You wouldn't be, it'd just be, it'd be 15 minutes, I could come meet you wherever you want.
Perfect. So I have your phone number, I'll text him today. And I'll call you so we can do it Monday.
Okay, yeah, let's do it Monday for sure. I can meet you anywhere you want. It'll take 15 minutes, that's it.
Okay, no problem.
Okay, thanks Mustafa.
Okay, Donald.
Okay, thanks.
I'll talk to you soon.
Yeah. Look forward to it.
Okay. Bye.
Bye. And that was the last time I talked to Mustafa. I continued trying to call him regularly, but he had yet to answer. Eventually, I just gave up. Even though I was able to answer my original question about why shawarma was so popular in Ottawa, the story behind Mustafa remained a mystery. Why all the secrecy? And what happened to his old restaurants and partnership? And even more curious, what was his strange affiliation with Mangiano's Pizzeria? Regardless, the legend of Marouche and Mustafa still lives on. I can only hope to one day meet him and hear his story. So if you're watching this, Mustafa, I'm still waiting for your call.
Marouche, Marouche, the best Middle Eastern fair. Marouche, Marouche, for shawarma and doner. Marouche, Marouche, right near the Scotia Bank. Marouche. On Elgin, south of Frank. It's quaint design.
the Frank.